Everyone, welcome sa ating online Sunday service sa mga nag-tune in sa kanilang mga bahay-bahay here in Philippines and also abroad. And also yung mga first time na mga mag-join sa atin, welcome po. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So can we all stand up as we start this service with a prayer? Hallelujah, Lord Jesus, we praise you, we glorify you, Lord. Thank you for this wonderful day that you have given unto us, this new life and breath, O Lord God, that we are here once again standing before you. We ask for your Holy Spirit to come and invade us today. Come and saturate us, O Lord God. We long for your mighty move wherever we are right now. We pray, Lord God, that we will receive something supernatural from you today. Oh, we welcome your presence, your power, and your glory. Strip me back, oh, for my pride, my possessions. Till all I want and all I see is your presence. Awaken us. Awaken me. Fire.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord God. For only in your presence, Lord God, we are complete.
I'll see.
alone we find our refuge. In you alone we find our rest, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Christ alone, I place my trust and find my glory in the past.
Hi, mga kapatid dito sa Cordillera, Philippines, and overseas. Have a wonderful day po sa lahat. All of us are blessed with the message last week. Truly, God is our restorer. He restores everything that have been lost. Though Satan has the agenda to destroy, but God has the agenda to restore. Our third lesson to our The Lord is My Shepherd, Psalm 23 series, is conquering the valley of the shadow of death. In Psalms chapter 23, verse 4, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. So in this lesson, we'll tackle this valley. What this valley for us, then the shadow, then the death, and I fear no evil, and you are with me. It is very interesting to note that shepherds do not only lead their sheep through the mountain or high ground, but also take them through valleys. Many of us think that if God is with us, He will lead us only on the higher ground. But a valley speaks of the low times and low seasons of our lives. We learn how the shepherd does not leave the sheep in valleys, but leads them through the dark and frightening valleys and back to the high ground. Hankadinga daituti description na iti our very own lives. How many times have we been through the dark and lonely valleys when it was only the voice of the shepherd that sustained us? Maminanumat nga iti church members nakadipindarda, iti reassurance, iti pastor da, iti leader da. And so, tatayo nga under shepherds, pastors, and leaders, we must be strong. We must be a deliverer and a helper to our flocks, to our disciples, because they are depending unto us. Okay, first let us discuss the valley. What is valley? Valley is a deep hollow between mountains. Diba kasi tayo ito bagyo, dati may isang barangay. Ito'y Baguio City na hollow. It is happy hollow. ay nalitang happy halo, ijay, bababa, iti likod, iti kam dyan, hey. It is a valley na unag. Ijay, nagtungaan iti bantay. But it always has deep waters, streams, and wells flowing through. Diyan iti blessing, pagsayaata na iti valley. Iti big, food, ijay. Iti ships, iti danong, ijay. Shepherds love valleys because of the green grass growing there that can be good food for their flocks. The fact that it is flanked by mountains on both sides shades if from direct sunlight. Kaya malilinungan. Kaya mayati weather na, alamin. Duti agtubo ijay. Napintas nga pag napintas nga pasture land. So, kaya't iti pastor nga ipan iti ships da ijay. And sometimes, kasyemot ka tayo. Though, we walk to the valley of the shadow of death. Antay yung agbuteng, and we have to pass through there because that valley can be a valley of blessing. Amen. Valley is covered by the shadow of the mountains. The height of the mountains could impose darkness on the valley. At daytime, and the prevailing temperature will be very cool. As cool and good as the valley, it is a place where terrible animals are found. Animals like bears, wolves, serpents, tigers, lions, and others. Why? Because they like the atmosphere of the valley. Can ada iti food, ijay nga place. Ada iti water, river there. So, kaya't da. Though it's a good place, a valley, but it's a dangerous place, especially for ships, tag iti karnero. Nga, awan, naadal tayo nga, awan iti weapons da. Awan iti sense of danger kada kuada. So, very fragile, no? Ships ti mapan eject at kasapulan iti pastor to protect them. Amen. It could be in a valley that David fought with bears and lions, and he won because the Lord was with him. In the valley, there could be thunderstorms and flood and rockings falling and slides from the mountains. Yamati riskina iti danger iti valley, yeah, that nalakanga dati flood, dati falling rocks, slati Canaan Road that is a valley. It is between two big mountains, that very dangerous ijay nga Canaan Road because agtudulong ti basit ket adoti matnag nga bato ket adon iti aksidente ijay nga natanagan iti bato. And there are slides also. And flood. No, napigsa dya, raging dya, danon because of storm. Very dangerous. And as cool as the valley is, it could be very dangerous. Kasta iti valley. Now, what kinds of valley we are passing through? In Psalms chapter 84, verse 6, even when their path winds through the dark valley of tears. So, that kind of valley that the psalm is talking about is the valley of weeping. It is a dark valley and valley of tears. Weeping. They dig deep to find a pleasant pool where others find only pain. Because of pain, ang outburst si tao, ang weeping. He gives to them a brook of blessing filled from the rain of an outpouring. But behind that valley, dark valley and valley of tears, there's a refreshing. There's a blessing. It's a brook of blessing filled from the rain of an outpouring. There is revival. There is restoration. There is rejoicing. Amen. But that kind of valley that we are passing through, the valley of weeping. So Psalm 84 talks about the valley of weeping. It is an uncontrollable weeping. Ang mga makontrol ti sales mo, and there you just cry and cry and weep and weep and weep. Why? Because of bitter experiences, napait. Because of betrayal, they betrayed you. They backbite you, they destroyed your life. Or it is because of your wrong decision, kat na-scam ka, na inalilaw da ka. Or it can be a disaster, calamity, earthquake, pandemic. Or it can be frustration. Nag-apply ka, nag-gastos-gastos ka, saan mo lang ang natuloy? Frustration. Pinaasa-asa ka di boyfriend mo, di girlfriend mo, but at the end, in-break ta ka. So, frustration. And that is your valley of weeping. Then in Hosea chapter 2, verse 15, God, what kind of valley that we are passing through? Hosea 2, verse 15, God is the only one who can make the valley of trouble. And so Hosea talks about the valley of trouble. You are in trouble. Mayroon kang problema. May nangyari na masama. Trouble. That is valley. Valley of trouble. But praise God, according to Hosea chapter 2, verse 15, that valley of trouble, God will make a door of hope. So just like the valley of weeping, behind the valley of weeping, there is revival, there is rejoicing. And behind this valley of trouble, there is a door of hope. Amen. And so it's right now, the valley of calamity, the valley of sickness, the valley of financial loss, the valley of frustration, the valley of marital turbulence and disgrace, can be the valley of dishonor and shame. And anuman ang valley na yan, ano? And the most dangerous one is the valley of the shadow of death. Kabut-butan. Iti aniniwan, iti patay. But praise God, from all those kinds of valley that we are passing through, the outcome of all those kinds of valley is the valley of blessings. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, the valley of blessing, the result. Now, there are five facts about dark valleys that we are passing through. Number one, it is unavoidable. They are going to happen in life. You can count on it. You may be coming out of one right now, or you may be in the middle of one right now, or you are heading into one right now. No matter what, dark valleys are unavoidable. Awan pilpilin na. Umay nga umay data. Saan nga malapdan? So Job chapter 5 verse 7, it says that mankind is born for trouble. As surely as sparks fly upward. Nayanak tayo. Nayanak tayo for trouble. That's the reality. That's life on earth. So dark valleys are unavoidable. So we have to prepare for it. We have to face it. We have to overcome it. And praise God, we have our shepherd. He's always there for us. Just depend and trust Him. Amen. And so if you are human, of course we are human, there will be dark valleys in your life. Unavoidable. So we have to strengthen our heart, our spirit, our faith to face it. Amen. And number two, dark valleys are unpredictable. You cannot plan them or time them, schedule them, because dark valleys are unscheduled, unpredictable. Hamot mo balin nga ako nang ay into no next month ang adanak ti trouble. Cannot say that. Ano, jay December ang adak jeti weeping. Cannot say that. The valley of weeping, no. So they usually come at the worst time. Like the Bible character, Joseph. In mighty valleys of dark valleys na. at the worst time, one after the other. Lakod, ay kakabsat na iso na, pinadakas, then they accused him as a rapist, imprisoned him, nalipatan, then ang tulong kanya na, nalipatan na. They come at the worst time. Job, biglang and medagiti, one after the other nga, robbers, nalada dadyay, kinabak na nga, may na, tayo sa nga pulong aputot na, the following day, nagkasakit. They usually come at the worst time, so we have to strengthen our faith. We have to always be in the presence of God. Kapsat, dahil ito yung pandemic, dahil ito yung trial ng umay, this is just to strengthen our faith. This is just for us na to face it and to overcome it, and God the promise. Ngamin no, there's no other way. Ngamin no, paaba ka, back out ka, backslide ka, isardang mo iti faith mo kani Apo Diyos, agbababawi ka. When rapture comes, we'll be left behind. No saan ka pa yung nagbabawi, sudden to death, apang kanja impyerno, naladaw ti amin, permiti babawi, naladawan. And so if that is life nga unavoidable, unpredictable, it is valleys to come in our lives, it always be prepared to face it in the presence of God. Amen. When you do not have time for them and are unprepared for them, that's the time that they will come. No wonder nga, adu dagiti nag-back out. Adu dagiti isang anak patpatuloy. May stress da, may mental blackout da, may depressed da, until they ended into mental hospital, to hospital, to the grave, far be it from you and me. So, at adalan tayo da ito'y that is unavoidable, unpredictable, no choice but to face it with God, our great shepherd. Amen. So usually they come when we have to be somewhere and are running late. Kita niyo tiko na nata, Jeremiah chapter 4 verse 20. Disaster after disaster is reported, for the whole land is destroyed. Suddenly my tents are destroyed. Suddenly. Biglaan. My tent curtains. In a moment. In just a moment. Time that you are unprepared. Time that you are late. Time that you are there somewhere. So we must be alert. So Jesus said, watch and pray. Especially today yung situation tayo. One after the other, titest ng umay. Sapul nga, watch and pray. Amen. And we have to be a fighter, overcomer. So what can you do? Dark valleys are unpredictable. So you have to trust in the direction of our chief shepherd, our Lord Jesus Christ. Number three, dark valleys are impartial. No one is immune. No one escapes the problems of life. Everyone has problems. Good people and bad people. Problems do not care how good or how bad you are, how rich or poor you are, educated or uneducated you are. Do you think you should be exempt from problems? Han, problems happen everyone, including you and me. Umay nga umay day ta. Impartial. So, Matthew chapter 5, verse 45, God causes His Son to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. Both righteous and unrighteous, Christians and unchristians, evil people and good people, parehas. Antayo nga kuna nga exempted dagiti born again. Exempted dagiti active na Kristiyano. No. Impartial. Number four, dark valleys are temporary. They have an end. They do not last forever. They are not our permanent residence. When you are in a dark valley sometimes, we think we are in a cave that has no way out. No, you are not. Dark valleys are like a tunnel. There is light at the other end because it's temporary. troubles in your life do not come to stay. They come to pass. Maawan mo't lang dagita. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, the suffering won't last forever. It won't be long before this generous God who has great plans for us in Christ, eternal and glorious plans they are, will have you put together and on your feet for good. They will not last forever. Mapukaw damot lang, aglabas da, awan mat lang, just like iti rabiing nga, maawan mat lang. Can any other calamities nga maawan da, they are not forever. Because they are temporary. Even if you live 80 or 90 years and have problems all your life, that is so insignificant compared to the thousands and millions of years you have been heaven. Eternal in heaven is a problem free. 5 minutes in a dentist chair getting a root canal can seem like eternity, but in reality, it is but a short time. Kapadasa. Maduti pinastaan na itingipan ko. I-drill da yung nag-permiti pain, unbearable. Kas lang eternal nga pain. But it is very, very short time. After that, it produces a great result. Good, healthy teeth. Kita nyo, teeth ko tata. Dalang ti may isang adakong kunanan. Can you see the teeth of your neighbor? Pain is just a temporary. Problems are temporary, but heaven is eternal. Number 5, dark valleys have a purpose. God has a reason for taking you through dark valleys. Whether you have a valley of doubt, despair, discouragement, or defeat, God has a reason behind it. We think that valleys are unnatural. They are not. They are a natural part of the landscape. There are financial valleys, relationship valleys, emotional valleys, all kinds of valleys in our lives. We'll get through them in time. Itahan tayo yung 1 Peter chapter 1, 6 to 7. You rejoice in this, though now for a short time you have had to be distressed by various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more valuable than gold, which perishes though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. So this verse tells us 3 things. Every problem has a purpose. The small problems or the big problems all have a purpose. They are there to, letter A, to help shape you. As metal is put into the fire to make it pliable, so we go through problems in life. The fire heats the metal so it can be shaped and made useful. The sudden change in temperature tempers the steel and makes it stronger. So mapaluk nang when it goes through the fire, that metal, get reshaped into a good, beautiful design that pleases the owner. The same thing in the sight of God. Ado ti kinlunga biyag tayo, natangkan ti tultul tayo, pagkurkurangan tayo, rebellious tayo, unrighteous tayo. And so God allows those valleys to help shape us into the design that pleases God na nagmayat na panagbiag tayo kakapsat. Only those who have been through such dark valleys, letter B, can console, comfort, encourage others in similar situations. So, second lesson from our valleys is that from our experience, we can now have an anointing or that influence to console, to comfort, and encourage others because we are talking with experiences. We are giving a piece of advice with experience from the scripture. Amen. Most of us do not want valleys in our lives. We shrink from them with a sense of fear and foreboding. Yet, in spite of our worst misgiving, God can bring great benefit and lasting benediction to others through those valleys. Takal ti pakausaran. Pakausaran tayo. Ta napadas tayo dagita. But with great blessing. So it is with us when we are under the shepherdhood of Christ. He takes that darkness, dark valley, and uses it to our faith. How do you know if you will be faithful? If you are faced with unfaithfulness, how do you know how much endurance you have unless you have to face tough times? How do you know if you can trust God, have faith in God in difficult times unless you go through tough times, great trials? Because the goal of God in your life, in my life, is not to make us comfortable. But the goal of God for you and me, and letter C, is to build your character out of those dark valleys. So let us face and welcome all our dark valleys because it builds our character. So God is preparing you for eternity. Then, letter B, about shadow. The reality of the shadow. Ti Lucano na ti shadow kat aniniwan. No, aldawan, adadya init. Kahit makitam di aniniwan mo. Kahit no makitam di aniniwan mo, dakdakkel di aniniwan mo, nusika. Adaba aniniwan ko to eh. Wala. Dakdakkel di aniniwan, nusika. So first, shadows are always bigger than reality. Kahit umay ti buteng, fear is always greater than the problems you face. That's reality. No adamot iti shadow of the problem, dagita nga problema nga umayken ka, sakit, bad news, ket umay ti buteng ket dakdakkel di buteng no diay problema. That's the shadow. A figure produced from the blockage of light by another figure. Han nga real thing dita, aniniwan lang. And number two, reality of shadow. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Number two, shadows cannot hurt you. Sige man, or may di tiger. May di aniniwan di tiger. That aniniwan of the tiger, shadow of the tiger cannot hurt you. Because it's just a shadow. Shadows cannot hurt you. They can only scare you. A representation of it, the shadow of a dog cannot bite because it is not the real animal. The shadow of a serpent cannot bite. The shadow of a gun cannot kill. It is just a shadow. So, kakabsat, do not fear the shadow. When you go through the valley, the shadow of death, do not fear. Number three, reality of the shadow. Shadows only appear when there is a light source. Awan ay tanga shadow without the light. But with the light, there is shadow. And we know that God is the light. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. We are the light of this world. Because of the light, shadow comes. No matter how dark a shadow could be, it reminds one of the presence of light. Because it is when light is shielded that a shadow is produced. So, the back of that shadow, there's light. When that light, silawan na ti death, agparang ti shadow. So we go to God, the light. You may be in a dark valley right now. You're in trouble. You are weeping. But there is a light at the end of the tunnel. That is silaw. The Bible says that God is light and in Him there is no darkness. So trust Him. Believe in Him because dito nga, serious tayo, the Lord is my shepherd. Psalm 23:1-4, I shall not want. We must believe in Him because He makes me to lie down in green pastures. We must believe Him because He leads us beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for His namesake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. It's the shadow, the reality of the shadow. Now, let's go to the death, the shadow of the death. I walk in the valley of the shadow of death. Death has no power. Death has overcome by Christ's death and resurrection. Hebrews chapter 2:14-15. Since the children have flesh and blood, He too shared in their humanity, so that by His death, He might break the power of Him who holds the power of death, that is the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by their fear of death. So through the death and resurrection of Christ, death has been defeated. Satan has been defeated, the source of death. Sin already has defeated. When Jesus rose from the grave, He conquered death. Revelation chapter 1 verse 18, Behold, I hold the keys of death and Hades. I have authority over death and Hades. They have no power. Because in Matthew chapter 28 verse 18, all authority had been given to Jesus. So share authority to Satan. And there's no power to Satan. There's no power even to death. So nawayawayan tayo. Kawanan ti panakabalin ti death. Amen. So in John chapter 11, verse 25 and 26, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? Lord, we believe your word. So nadaman ti earthquake, adaman iti mang darup, mang patay ka na, whatever. Hawan, hantay nga butang ti death, but we rebuke death. Kahit kunan ni Jesus Christ, ito, John chapter 11, hantay mapadasan ti physical death because we will be raptured. That tayo, the last nga generation, that yung people that are there, the last generation. And we will be raptured. Rapture means in the twinkling of an eye, sudden change of your body. No physical death. Then we fly to meet the Lord in the air. In the twinkling of an eye. Nung matay tayo physically, but we will rise up and we'll live. So there's no power of death. Death cannot hold you because you will resurrect to life. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 15:55-58. Where, O death, is your victory? Where is your power? Where, O death, is your sting, your power? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord. Because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Because there's victory no more. No power of death. Then the last, letter D, I will not fear. I will fear no evil. Anak ng buten. Ore no adakati dark valleys. There's the shadow of death. Saan tayo ngagbuten? Padas mo man nga pan iti haunted house. Mga kangagbuten, I will fear no evil. The Dakaji tunnels, the dark place. The word of God says, I will fear no evil in the shadow of death. So refuse to be discouraged. David put his faith in God and walked through the valley of the shadow of death. Just imagine, ipakamkamat ni King Saul. They wanted to kill David. Ngayon na ito'y tinagturturungan ni David ngayon. He came at the dark valleys, places. He ran after his life because King Saul, papatay na iso na. Saan nagbutang ni David? He put his faith in God. Though he walked through the dark valley, though he walked the valley of the shadow of death, at mang patpatay kanya na. And sometimes, adati kasi mga mangyari, tibiyak tayo. But praise God, tagtagay na po gayam. All kinds of death comes to kill us anywhere, any place. Kukutbutang. Then suddenly you woke up, it's a dream. And sometimes it's reality. One after the other, nga problema nga umumay. You're walking through the dark valleys or the shadow of death. And God is whispering to you, do not fear. Fear not. So we need to refuse to be discouraged. And we must walk through this valley. We cannot go around the valley. Mabaling nagrikos-rikos ka lang nita nga valley, no? Nga, kasla nangyari the wilderness dagiti the Israelites. They go around the wilderness and they died there. It cannot be, we do not allow that we go around iti dark valleys tayo then we die there. Kakabsat, hangkang nga you go around iti balim, iti problema, iti bad situation mo, iti yung pandemic, but maulaw-ulaw ka, kat matay ka ita. Spiritual death or physical death? No. And we cannot go under the valley. Nga ibadbadak da kalatan, nga mabutbutang ka under the evil influence. Nga dati problema, dati tanga situation, kat you go under that problem, kat iturturayan da ka, no. We cannot go around the valley, we cannot go under the valley, nor can we go over it. Nga ibadbadak mo latan, nga ije kalatan. No. The Word of God says we can only go through it. Labasan tayo, kakabsa. Labasan tayo. We go through. Amen. And do not fear. Malampasan tayo matlayan. Data, masukatan ti dakkel nga blessing. So how can we not be discouraged? Sanungan tayo nga buteng. It is by focusing on God's power rather than our problems. Two people in identical situations will generally react differently. The difference is what they are focusing on. When we focus on our circumstances, on your problem, on your dark valley, then our circumstances will rule our lives. Instead, we need to start focusing on Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our faith. Don't focus on the situation. Don't focus on your valleys. Don't focus on that problem. But rather focus on the Savior, Jesus Christ. Don't focus on the problems, but on God's power over the problem. Tantay ni Jehoshaphat, the valley of blessings. I told you a while ago that with all those dark valleys, those shadows of death, those bad valleys, there's also it will result into the valley of blessings. Second Chronicles chapter 20, 25 to 26. King Jehoshaphat and his men went out to gather the plunder. They found vast amounts of equipment, clothing, and other valuables, more than they could carry. There was so much plunder. that it took them 3 days just to collect it all. Ayun, nagkato. Fast. So huge. Nagkato nga blessing. On the fourth day, they gathered in the valley of blessing. Patnal daw. Nag-gathered the Ija in valley of blessing, which got its name that day because the people praised and thanked the Lord there. It is still called the Valley of Blessing today. Nagmahit nga panpasyaran na ito eh. Until now, katinaga na day takot, Valley of Blessing. So, ano ba the situation na day to eh? In 2 Chronicles chapter 22-3, a great multitude is coming against Jehoshaphat and his people in Judah from beyond the sea. Akasam na beyond the sea. From Syria, and they are in Hazazon Tamar, which is in Engedi. So no, ija Engedi kat ija inti along iti Dead Sea. Kit ija manan Syria kat the other side. So meaning to say, vast armies are coming to attack Jehoshaphat and the Israelites. Just like our nation, the Philippines, so a small nation with a 109 million population and with a few armies. And when the China and Russia will come with their vast armies to come to attack the small nation of the Philippines, of course, we will fear. Abutang tayo. Just like Jehoshaphat, he feared. But the good news for Jehoshaphat is, he said in verse 3, and set himself to seek the Lord, and proclaimed a fast throughout all Judea. So, anong gagawin natin when a vast enemies, vast big problems will come? Jehoshaphat, seek the Lord. Verse 12, oh, our God, will you not judge them? For we have no power against this great multitude that is coming against us, nor do we know what to do. And the second good news for Jehoshaphat, he said, but our eyes are upon you. Kanina, they seek God. Second, their eyes are upon God. Verse 17, you will not need to fight this battle. Kunani Apo Diyos, God answered. Position yourself instead. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, who is with you, or His presence who is with you. O Judah and Jerusalem, do not fear, aking abutan, or be dismayed. Tomorrow, go out against them, for the Lord is with you. So the third good news for them is, do not fear. Seek the Lord. Amen. Birukan ni Apo Diyos. Put your eyes on God. Third, do not fear. Fourth, go out, go to the valley. So how to turn our dark valleys into the valley of blessings? As lalito ni Jehoshaphat. So first, seek God with fasting. And so I mean, coming up pastors, and we instructed our elders and leaders, at least adati once a week nga fasting. Panagayunar. Not only a fast in preparation or this for the Sunday service, for our date with God, but also fasting to seek the Lord. Fasting for cleansing, restoration. And besides our weekly fasting, we have 5 levels annual prayer and fasting. And now we are now in the 4th level. First level is the 3 days normal fasting, usual in January. Then the second level is the 7 days prayer and fasting in March. Then the third level is 14 days prayer and fasting. We did it last May. And now July and August, the 4th level of prayer and fasting, 21 days from July 19 to August 8. And I encourage each one to join us as one family. And then the 5th level of our prayer and fasting will be on October and November, that is 40 days. So seek God with fasting so that we can turn our dark valley into the valley of blessing. So that yung lesson natin last week, restoration will come. So it connects our topic restoration last week and our topic this week, conquering the valleys of the shadow of death. Second, how to turn our darkest valleys into the valleys of blessings is focus on God. So Jehoshaphat feared the vast army coming to kill and to destroy them. And so what he did, he put his eyes on God. Do not put your eyes on your problem, on your darkest valley. Put your eyes on God because God is bigger than your valleys. Then third, verse 20, Jehoshaphat encouraged his people and said, put your faith in God as you focus on Him. Not only in God, but put your faith in His servants, in His prophets. So have faith in your pastor, in your leader. Believe them. What we are doing is that the senior pastor is receiving revelation from God, the anointing, the blessing from God, and then we have our mentoring, and I am going to impart it to our elders, to our workers. Then the workers and the leaders, your leaders, they will impart it to you. Show your faith to your leader, to your pastor, in connection your faith to God. That is always the structure of God. It cannot be nga ko na mga Lord, I love you, but I do not love my pastor. It cannot be. It cannot be nga, Lord, I have faith in you, but I do not have faith in on my pastor, on my leader. Cannot be. So you must understand. Amen. And the fourth, how to turn our darkest valleys into the valley of blessings. We have to praise and worship. We have to put on the garment of praise. Second Chronicles chapter 20, verse 22, as they began to sing and praise, ambush came to their enemies. God fought their fight, and God ambushes the enemies of the Israelites. Not by might nor by power, but by God, but by the Spirit of God. Just praise God and thank God. Rejoice. And God will do in the spiritual realm. And the enemies being destroyed, the spirits of those, the spirit behind, nakita nga, darkest valleys tayo will be consumed and will be destroyed. Praise and worship. The power of praise and worship. The power of music. And the last number 6, Jehoshaphat said, now, let us go. Because that's the instruction of God. God instructed the Jehoshaphat and God said, go now. After the praise and worship, apang kayon? Verse 24 to 26, apang kayon, Egypt Valley. So, we are commanded to go to our valleys, to the darkest valleys. Pantayo. You cannot turn that darkest valleys into the valley of blessings if you do not go.
Ang kakutubastak tutukaw, titak-tatak doritak ko. Forward, move forward. Atam di kaabay mo, go. Let's go. You must go through your valley. Amen. And the result, you gather the plunder. King Jehoshaphat, verse 25, and his men went out to gather the plunder. Mapantayo, tayo-gather tayo, tagitang a blessing. Amen. They found vast amounts of equipment, clothing, and other valuables, more than they could carry. Agasom na ito, vast amounts, meaning vast amounts, nagado, nagdakal, huge blessing. There's a huge blessing in our valley, so we must go. There was so much plunder that it took them 3 days just to collect it all. Hanlang 1 day, 2 days, but 3 days, nagado, a blessing. There's so much blessing in the valley, kakapsat. Your darkest valley will become a great blessing. Great valley of blessings. On the fourth day, they gathered in the valley of blessing, which got its name that day because the people praised and thanked the Lord there. It is still called the valley of blessing today. So you name your darkest valley as a valley of blessing. Not the problema, not the crisis, not the situation. You thank God. Lord, thank you for these valleys. Amen. Because that is the valley of blessings. So our conclusion. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. So God will turn your valley of trouble into a door of hope. Hosea chapter 2 verse 15. God is the only one who can make the valley of trouble a door of hope. Nilang Apo Diyos kakabsat. If you put your faith in God. If you go to God, do not fear. Only God can make your valley of trouble into a door of hope. Amen. So transform your darkness into any blessings from the valley of devastation into the door of restoration. The valley of stress into the door of salvation. The valley of unemployment into the door of deployment. The valley of refusal into the door of renewal. The valley of confusion into the door of decision. The valley of darkness into the door of direction. The valley of loss into the valley door of life. The valley of poverty into the valley of provision. The valley of fear into the valley of faith. The valley of refusal into the valley of renewal. The valley of confusion into the door of decision. The valley of breakdown into the valley of breakthrough. The valley of failure into the valley of fullness. From the valley of testing into the valley of triumph. The valley of personal challenge into the valley of personal growth. The valley of rejection into the valley of redirection, and the valley of dead end into the door of destiny. Let us all arise. Hallelujah. God loves you so much. God is your shepherd. He is your Jehovah Jireh. God is your everything. Seek the Lord. Turn your darkest valley into the God blessings by seeking God, by putting your eyes, focusing your eyes on Jesus, by putting your faith in God into your leader. So do not fear. You must be ready to go to the valley of your blessings. Takder tayo kakapsat. Arise. And God is extending His love to you. He's saying to you, my son, my daughter, I love you. That darkest valley that you are going through, I am with you. I am your shepherd. I'm the one who lead you there. I know your pain. I know your what you are going through. But I'm leading you to that because I'm going to turn your trouble into a door of hope. I'm turning your darkest valley into a huge valley of blessings. So turn to God. Put your faith in God. Now I ask each one to pray to God. Yes, hallelujah. God had promised that He will take care of you. Just put your faith. Put your eyes on Him. In your trouble, in your darkest valleys, and God will direct you. Yes, yes, and I declare and decree, as you keep praying, that your valley of devastation, it will be the valley of your restoration. In your stress, salvation will come. In your valley of unemployment, the door of employment will come to you for your deployment. Yes, in that valley of rejection and refusal, restoration and renewal will come to you. In your confusion, in your valley of confusion, God will enlighten you for a right decision. In your darkness, there will be a direction. There is light coming to you. In your valley of loss, panakapukaw, you can find life. In your valley of poverty, there is provision. Yes, in your valley of fear, faith will be established in you. Though you've experienced rejection, refusal, God will accept you. And renew. Yes, God, even though you are in a breakdown, God will lead you to the door of breakthrough. Or ano, nag-fail it in life mo, God will lift you up and fill you. Or ano, dagat it testing, you will overcome that. That is the door of triumph for you. Very challenging, but you will grow. In those challenges, you will grow. Yes. There's no end because there's a valley of destiny. God is always with you. Yes. Yes, hallelujah. God will turn your trouble into the door of blessing. God will turn your darkest valleys into a vast valley of blessings because God loves His servants. Oh, Rasha Karada, sige, pray, keep praying to God. Lord, hear the prayers of your people. Lord, all these things, Lord, that had been declared, it will come to pass to each one. And we receive, Lord, we go, Lord, to our vast valley of blessings. All those darkest valleys, if you are going to turn it, Lord, to a door of hope. Opening of another door of blessings to come. So God, we just continue put our faith in you. Trust unto you. As we focus our eyes on you, God, not on our problem. And you are going to turn everything into blessing. Praise be unto you, God. Thank you so much. Dagito yun nga panang minsayim kada kami, panang sagid mo kada kami, panaka-enlighten me, kat Lord, saan kami nga buteng ti, darkest valley me, saan kami apo nga magpaabak, the Lord, saan kami nga matras, saan kami nga back out, ang backslide. No, but Lord, we move forward because it become our vast valley of blessings. It is a door of blessing, Lord. Salamat for that. Salamat, Lord. And now, adan kami ti confidence, Lord. Faith, Lord, nga mapan iti valleys me Anyaman nga validate ta. We are ready to face all our valleys, O God. Because we know and we know nga blessing dagita da Apo Dios. So we give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you so much, Lord. Thank you so much, Lord. And all the people of God will say, Amen and Amen. God bless everyone.
Hi, church. It's giving time. I would like to quote this verse from Malachi 3 verse 10. This is very familiar, but this is the most promising verse to all of us who believe in God. So it says in this verse that bring the full 10% into the storehouse so that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord of hosts. See if I will not open the floodgates of heaven and pour out a blessing for you without measure. So in this verse, God is inviting us to test Him. Why? There is a blessing that is awaiting for us. So if we give our 10%, God is also testing us to put our trust in Him, to put our needs in Him, because God provides everything. He is our Jehovah Jireh. And aside from our tithes, we must also give our offering. So offering, it shows our generosity. It shows how we love God. It shows how we honor God in our life. So I do believe that one of the reasons why people don't give their tithes in offering or why they don't live their life generously is because they are afraid. Fear prevents you from giving. So why fear if we know that the blessing of God is super overflowing? It says in a verse, Malachi 3 verse 10, He will open the floodgates of heaven. So what we are waiting for, church? So I encourage you, we must overcome fear, because fear is not comes from God. It is from the devil. So if you want to experience breakthroughs, supernatural provisions of God, blessings, this is it. God is inviting us. So, church, let's give our tithes and our offering cheerfully. Let's remain standing as we declare these declarations. As we give our full tithes and offering, I and my family will have an open heaven life. Blessings so great, I and my family can't contain. I and my family will have super abundant crops. I and my family are well guarded. I and my family will live in good health. Nothing will be wasted in my life and in the life of my family. My life and my family are such a delight, and nations will call us blessed and prosperous. Yes, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this avenue to bless your name, O God. Bless everyone who give their tithes in their offering as they put their trust in you, O Lord. Lord, we declare that this declaration shall come to pass as we continue to apply the blood of Jesus from the crown of thorns for authority, for dominion, and prosperity. And you will raise up kingly investors into your kingdom right now, O God. And also we apply the blood of Jesus from his hands for productivity, creativity, and all our works, O Lord God, all the sources from our income, there is anointing that is overflowing, O God. So Lord, we bless you. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us have this Holy Communion. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 24 to 29. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So then, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. Everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat of the bread and drink from the cup. For those who eat and drink without discerning the body of Christ eat and drink judgment on themselves. That's why many of you are sick and some already died." So brethren, before we partake this Holy Communion, everyone, let us bow down our heads. Let us ask God to search us, and let us confess our sin, and we ask the mercy, the grace of God to forgive and to cleanse us, and ask the Holy Spirit that he will make us worthy to partake the elements of the Holy Communion. Sige, lahat po tayo, manalangin, hingi po tayo ng patawad as we admit ang ating mga kasalanan. Yes, Lord, God, hear the prayer of your people, the confession, the repentance of your people. God, make us worthy to partake the elements of the Holy Communion. Yes, thank you, Jesus, for being the Lamb that was slain, your blood that was shed for us, for our salvation. Cleanse and forgive us of all of our sin. Purify your people. Purify your people. Let your blood covers our sin, God. Thank you, thank you. Thank you that we are now worthy to partake the Holy Communion. In Jesus' name, amen. So, prepare now the elements. You get your bread. I have bread here. And then prepare your cup. Okay. This bread symbolizes the body of Christ that was suffered, flogged with 39 lashes, beaten, spanked. You know, they put crown of thorns around his head. And Jesus was in agony, he was nailed, his hands was nailed, and his feet was nailed, and was crucified. But through his death on the cross, we receive miracle of salvation. Salvation from sin, salvation from sickness, salvation from curse. And this cup represents the blood of Christ that was shed for the forgiveness of our sins and for our divine protection, for protection against this COVID-19. And so let's have this communion to remember what Jesus did for us. This is the basis of our salvation. Because Jesus Christ is the only Savior. Okay, let us pray. Lord, bless and sanctify this bread that symbolizes the body of Christ that was suffered on the cross. And Lord, this cup, bless this cup representing the blood of Christ that was shed on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins and our divine protection. As we do this, Lord, Holy Spirit, move and touch and lead each one. In Jesus' name, amen. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Kainin po natin ang tinapay. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Inumin po natin ang cup. Oh, let us express our thanks to the Lord, our gratitude, our worship, because he is worthy. Our Father who loves us so much, our Lord Jesus Christ who gave him his life for us. Pasalamat tayo sa kanya, and the Holy Spirit who convicted and leading us to Christ. So let us worship and give thanks to our Father, to our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the Holy Ghost. Thank you so much of what you have done for us, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your love. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you so much, Lord. Lord, for the miracle of our salvation, of our healing, of our good health, deliverance, our salvation. Thank you, even for the abundant life, prosperous life through Christ, Lord. We live, O God, an abundant life. Thank you so much, Lord. We give you praise and we give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Okay, church, let's all remain standing as we declare Psalms 23 over our lives, over our family, and over our nation. Okay, so let's declare. 1, 2, 3. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely, the goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
As we remain standing, we'll go now to the benediction. Raise your hands to the Lord and receive the benediction. The benediction is the priestly blessing from the senior pastor. And this is a very, very powerful priestly benediction declaration. Okay? Brethren, because you have sacrificed your time to be with the Lord in this online service to God, date with the Lord, and you have received those words that God had prepared for you, and acknowledged and believed and accepted the Lord as your Jehovah Jireh, receive now the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Shalom. Nothing lacking, nothing missing, nothing broken. And may the great wealth and favor of the Lord be upon you. And I also declare blood covering to become upon you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless.
So family, you don't have to worry about your dark valleys. After all, they are not dark and they are the doors to your blessings. Kaya we encourage you to come here with our face-to-face service dito on Saturday at 10 a.m., on Sunday at 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. Pero huwag po tayo mag-alala para sa mga kapatid natin abroad and sa amang sulok ng Pilipinas, tuloy-tuloy pa rin po tayo sa ating online service on Sunday at 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Pero mas masaya, nandito tayo nagkakaisa, di ba family? To be more updated with the current events of our church, like, follow, and share our Facebook page. And we also have our YouTube channel, kaya subscribe na dyan, kapatid. And of course, inulit-ulit natin that giving is the antidote of crisis. Kaya we have our third wave of our first fruit offering on August 2. And of course, there's more. Para sa mga young people dyan, we are uploading new videos every Tuesdays and Fridays at 8 p.m. para mas makilala pa natin kung ano nga ba yung purpose natin, bakit andito tayo sa mundong ito. But there's another pages that we will be having para mas ma-encourage pa tayo to have our journey with God. We have Rich TV, Youth Talks, and Redeem. Kaya family, we would like to see you again next Sunday with your friends, with your neighbors, and with your Facebook friends. God bless and see you.